I know what it cost me for a click. I know what it cost me for a prospect. I know what it cost me for a lead. I know what it cost me for a contract. It's a funnel. Like if you're drawing it on your page, you would draw it like this, right? At the top of the funnel, how many people did you market to? How many prospects? How many calls? How many contracts? What did it close? What did I spend at the top of the funnel? What did I get out of the bottom? When you know those numbers, you win. Only works always. While most people are trying to play a game, running up and down the streets to find a deal, the guys that are doing it at a really big level, this is the game they're playing. Right? When they're sitting in those masterminds, and I talk about that, if you're not at the table, you're on the menu, this is what I'm talking about. You got guys that are trying to figure out how to go spend $1 million in marketing in a market and just go do 200 deals in the next 9 years. Those are the people that you're competing with. Whether you appreciate it or not does not make it any less true. It's absolutely happening. So when you know your KPIs, you can win. But until then, how many of you have ever experienced the marketing of, well, I just put a bunch of stuff in and I just kind of wait and see what comes out on the other end? Because that's what most people do. And if that's you, this is how you get through it. By the way, I'll give you another thing. If you're not marketing, then you get it. You're already on the backside of this. You're not controlling your own destiny. Somebody else is. You have to be out there generating your own deals. So with that, the next thing I would tell you is most people, when they market, they mail out a postcard about this size, right? Does that make sense? How many of you have ever done this or know to do this? Okay, most everybody. They go off and they mail, whether it's motivated sellers, cash buyers, this is what gets sent to them. Talking about knowing how to separate yourself and how to create a customer experience is very different. The reason why people do this is because it's inexpensive, right? I can get this done for somebody's door for 25 cents. So I can go mail 50,000 people for 12 grand. The problem with that is that you've done nothing to separate yourself. Would we all agree? How many of you ever walked into a house and seen a stack of these? Right? Happens all the time. You and everybody else did the exact same thing. Where are those mailers? Hey, let me see those. Okay. So when we mail to a seller, they get something, they say they'll get something like this, but we use these everywhere in our business. A seller from us gets this. When they open it up, and a video starts playing.
Wow.
Do you think I'm playing a different game? Do you think that creates a customer experience? Okay. Not only do they get this, they get this in a FedEx. Unless I can come back and I'll let you ask a question. They get it in a FedEx. So while you're mailing your 25-cent postcard, I spent $30 to mail this. I'm going deeper instead of wider. I don't mail 50,000 people. I mail 500. I spent the exact same amount of money you did. But I meant for the experience. You're hoping 0.5% open it. I know, because it's FedEx. What's the open rate on FedEx? 100%, baby. Everybody gets a FedEx open time. It's like Christmas, right? We don't know why, but we just want to open that thing, right? So I know every one of them got opened up, and then I got this in their hands. How many think this gets watched? Only always, right? It just works every time, right? And they pick up the phone, and they call. Now, do I convert all of them? Of course not. But do they remember me? Yes. And have I converted enough of them to create an empire? Yes. So that's the brand. Separate yourself. Now the key to that is the only way you can afford to do that is you have to clearly understand the list you're mailing to. Does that make sense? Because the reason why you would cast a wide net is you're hoping to catch everything. Right? You're hunting with a shotgun. The only way you can do hunt with a rifle is you have to know exactly the target you're going after. Okay? And again, I'll show you how to do that here in a second. But let's just all agree that the list matters in that scenario. Because if you're not dialed in with the right person and delivering the right message, it just doesn't you just wasted a bunch of money. Is that fair?
Yeah.
So create a significant customer experience all the time, and they will come back over and over and over, especially people that pay cash. And I know this to be true because, again, about 75% of our business at this point is only dealing with people that pay cash. Another thing I will tell you that when you're dealing with cash clients is cash investors, who hopefully everybody agrees, man, if I could just give people who just paid cash all the time, there's no headaches, and they just knew exactly what they wanted, and they just wanted to buy as many as they could from me. I mean, if somebody picked up the phone to you and called today and said, I have $5 million, burning a hole in my pocket, I need to buy 10 properties in the next 30 days, and I can close for cash in as little as 24 hours, what are you going to do next? Get moving, baby. Right? They just motivated you. And if that is true, which most of you will say, that is true, right? Then that should speak clearly to you how important cash buyers are. Clearly. Because it'll motivate you. So if you have all those buyers on your side, and they're behind you, and they're the people that you know you're going to sell properties to, that makes your job infinitely easier going out there and creating opportunities. All the guesswork's gone. Just done. I know exactly what my buyers want to buy. I know the areas I want to buy in. I know the returns on investment. I know what it looks like, etc. But more important than that is that last point. My cash buyers know what I stand for and what I stand against and what my core values are and what I'm willing to do and what I'm not willing to do. And they know clearly, and we're just, you know, seeing this in our operation many times. We say no much more than we say yes. Cash buyers call in. I got millions of dollars, right? But I need you to cut this corner or that corner. I need this return. Bye. See ya. We're not good for you. And the beauty of having the strength to do that is what happens is when you clearly know what your core values are, you have the ability to attract clients to you that want to be a part of that. We all want our tribe, right? Write that down. We all want to belong. We're all looking for our tribe. I would argue that's the reason why some of you are in this room right now. I just want to be around like-minded individuals that think the way I think, that are trying to do the same things I'm doing, that want to achieve things. Is that fair?
Yes.
Yeah, of course. We all want to belong. And so we're all looking for those people that we can belong with, that we can hang out with, we have these commonalities with. So when you get real clear on what your core values are as a company and as an individual, and you're able to express that, especially to cash buyers, they eat it up. And here's the best part. The people that are that you don't want to do business with, you will repel them immediately. So when I go out, I'll straight up say, hey, this is what I'm doing. This is where I'm going. Get on or get out. I don't care. Your money makes no difference in my life whatsoever. I'm way past that. And I mean it. It's just that's who I am. And if it pisses you off and you don't want to be a part of me, even better. Because that means I don't have to waste time with you. I have a wristband that I wear every single day. It says the time is now. Right? It's the motto of our company. One thing I know for truth that is absolutely certain is that thing you cannot waste is time. Why do I want to spend time with some jerk off that's going to waste my time as opposed to hanging out with my kids, my wife, my friends, or clients that really value me? So by being this way, I get to attract really powerful people. And I get to repel all the douchebags. Does that make sense? That's why it's got a 100% close rate. It just works every time. So knowing your core values, expressing those core values, creating a significant customer experience, the market will just reward you over and over and over. And it's not hard to do. It's just doing the right thing. I mean, there's nothing easier than what I'm talking about doing, by the way, guys. It's just being cool to your clients. That's all I'm talking about doing. I'm not telling you to go jump through a bunch of hoops. I'm not telling you to go raise a bunch of money. I'm not telling you to do any of that stuff. I'm just telling you, this is the easiest thing to do. Take care of people, and they will take care of you. A couple other things, and then I'm going to show you the software, and then I'm going to answer your questions. One thing that we've also found to be really, really powerful when we're going off, especially on appointments to buy properties, is we will send what we call an objection handling package. How many of you have ever walked in to get a property, whether it's a listing or a deal, and you sit there and you spend the first 2 hours just trying to get over all these objections to the whole beginning to have a conversation about them with them to get them to sell the house. I mean, you ever dealt with that, right? Hopefully everybody's dealt with it at some point. So, and if you haven't, you're certainly not trying hard enough. What we start doing is FedEx in a package tool, cookies, a company brochure. Here's the CMA on your property. Here's the representative we're going to send out to you. Here's about the representative's family, who they are, what we stand for. Basically, all of that rapport building stuff, including a video from the CEO of the company, right, is in their hands. I'm going to have somebody in your house at 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. But by 10 a.m., you've got a package from me that you're going through. Does it cost an extra $20 or $30? Yes. Did I already pay for the lead anyway? Yeah, I sent them this in the first place, right? They got this the first time. I already paid to generate the lead. Now they've called. Now they've set an appointment. I've already got money invested. All I'm trying to do is double down and get the deal. Does that make sense? And the moment we did that and changed that, our conversion rates went through the roof. Playing a completely different game. Walking in and helping them understand why we are so different. Because if I have to compete with you on price, and I have to compete with every other clown out there, we know that that's almost pointless. Right? You're only going to win a few of those battles. So you got to separate yourself every step of the way. Create a significant customer experience. A really good friend of mine by the name of, or a good friend of mine by the name of Frank McKinney. Anybody know who Frank McKinney is?
Yeah.
Okay. Frank McKinney is one of the most amazing guys you'll ever meet, but he is a guy that for many, many years was kind of the king of luxury spec homes. Right? So out in Florida, he would build spec homes of $20, $30, $40, $50 million. Well, basically less than 5,000 people on the planet could actually buy it. So he was taking all this massive risk. And this guy's been on Oprah, been on Ellen, been on front of USA Today. I mean, he's just an amazing, amazing guy. You learn a lot from guys like that that play at that level. Frank McKinney, McKinney.
Sorry.
You guys so he's okay. A part of our group. We work together a lot on our charity stuff. And he made one of the comments he made that I thought was really, really powerful. Last time I saw him. Because I can't, my whole focus is when I walk in the door, I have to make a significant front door impression. And what he meant by that is the moment they open the door, they're going to buy or sell right then. There's a lot of lessons right there. It's the same thing happens when you mail them, or the same thing happens when you walk in their house. This guy's selling $50 million houses, and he realizes that they're buying and selling in the first minute. And he stressed this to me in a point. It was a real, I'm going to make the story very quick. But he was like, Ken, one of the houses I sold for $15 million. He's like, and they walked in the door, and the guy was walking in with his brand new trophy wife, you know, second wife, 60-year-old guy, she's like 30, and he comes in, and he's trying to make, this guy's really trying to impress her. He's obviously buying the house for her, and I'm selling for $15 million. He comes in and offers me $9 million. I'm like, that's not happening. It's like, so we go back and forth and back and forth, and all this negotiation. All this is happening right in the first few minutes, right? And he's like, my Hummer is parked out there, and so basically we ended up at where we each win. It's like, I'll give you $14 million, but you got to throw in the Hummer. Okay. Right? But it gets better. They go through this whole process, and the guy's like, I want to sleep in it in 24 hours. Right? So he pays him all cash, wires it the next morning, and comes in the next afternoon, 24 hours later, to move into the house. Now, when he sells him these houses are always fully stocked. I mean, his whole advertising was bring a toothbrush. Right? Everything's done. And so, lines in the cellar, everything. So he talks about that. This guy walks in the next night, and they've done the deal, the money's come in. He's like, walks in, and Frank's in there. He's like, hey, come on in. He's like, all right, so now I need you to actually give me a tour of the house, because I haven't even seen the upstairs. This guy just spent $14 million and never actually walked through the property. So if you don't think that people won't spend money for an emotion, you are crazy. Right? They do it every day. When you can make somebody feel the way they want to feel, baby, they will spend a ton of money. Create that experience. And again, the beauty of real estate is that it's just not done. People don't do this, especially on the investment side. There's agents that do it. On the investment side, it's very rarely done. A couple of things I'll show you with you real quick. Just that this is a very tactical thing. Those of you that are getting old, that you're getting leads and they don't buy or you can't buy their house on the very first deal, I would tell you, one of the things we found to be very, very powerful is we use a piece of software called Sly Dial, S-L-Y-D-I-A-L, where it basically puts a voicemail into their mailbox without the phone actually ringing. So we will come back to a client 30 days later and place a voicemail in their mailbox. And keep in mind, we generate thousands of leads, so for us to physically call these people would be almost impossible. So a piece of software will do this very quickly. And we'll basically say, hey, we're purchasing homes in your area. We're going to close on a few this week. We just want to check back with you, see if we can buy your house. And that probably generates 5 to 7 deals a month for us by just doing that one little thing. Why? Because your competition will. The fortune is in the bottom. Right? We've all heard that. A few more things, real quick. Let me get to the software. I got about 10 minutes here. Bandit signs. I will tell you, they continue to be very, very viable in almost every market. We have investors in our network. Again, we have 61,000 people that use our software. We have thousands that are a part of our real estate worldwide community. This is stuff we hear on a consistent basis. Hundreds inside of our masterminds. Bandit signs are still something that's very, very viable. I will tell you a piece of software that works great with us called Simple Crew. S-I-M-P-L-E-C-R-E-W. It's a great way to have somebody go place the bandit sign and basically take a picture. And we'll place that on a map so that you as the manager can see, here's where all my bandit signs were placed. And then here's where they were all taken down without you ever leaving your house. Again, I said this earlier, but I'll say it again. Go wide for quantity and go deep if you want to go to no competition and highly profitable deals. The best marketing list when you're out there marketing for seller leads, property leads, is right there. Vacant properties that the owner is over the age of 55, the owner lives out of state, and they are finally financially distressed. Those are all ands, by the way. So these are not ors, these are ands. So vacant, owners over the age of 55, they live out of state with the property, and they are financially distressed. I'll show you how to generate that list in just a second. That list right there generates the vast majority of the deals in our network. Right now, just to give you, just in the United States, that list right there, everywhere in the market, is 2.2 million properties. So if you think, oh, it only generated a few here or there, no, it's 2.2 million properties today. Last thing, is this the last thing? Yeah, this is okay. Last thing, one of the things that we started doing also in our seller marketing campaigns is that on our second or third touches, we will send a letter to them, and the letter actually has a picture of the property. We use a piece of software called AccuPix that does that. It basically pulls the Google image. So our list goes in, it immediately pulls the image, and so they get a letter that says, hey, is this your property? Because we want to buy it. It looks like I drove by and took a picture. I'm sitting in La Jolla, California, and these lists are being generated from Memphis, Tennessee, Houston, Texas, Dallas, Texas, you know, anywhere. I can do it right now. Santa Barbara. And it takes an extra 30 seconds to do it. But the point is, by that one little piece of engagement, right? Nothing else in the letter changed except we put their picture of the property on it. Got us a 301% increase in our responses, which is significant, right? It's significant. Okay, two things real quick. I'm going to show you how to create the list, and then I'm going to open it up for questions before I have to get out of here. Because everybody always asks me how you generate the list. Again, I just kind of blew through this. If you want more information on the software, we'll leave you information, get it all set up. But this is our software that we use right now. Again, this is the piece of software that's used by roughly 60,000 active investors around the country. And we, to give you a little bit of background, what made me really successful in the grocery industry was that I went off, and when everybody else was getting this case of water, they would get a phone call from the Winn-Dixie or Safeway. Hey, we've got this truckload of water, we're gonna sell it to you. But they would call me and everybody else that was in this industry. And so we're all trying to sell the same thing, and it's a race to zero. So what we did is we went in the other direction. And this is how a 27-year-old kid takes an $800 million company and turns it into $1.8 billion. I just asked a dumb question. was so naive that I just said, why don't we just go ask our customers what they want and just give it to them? Which is what I just talked to you about here, right? But in the grocery industry, we just went out and said, hey, if I can sell you anything, any price, any day, any quality, what do you want? Oh, I want Kraft mac and cheese, I want Campbell's soups, I want Kellogg's cereal, I want Jimmy Mills Cheerios, and we would go and get it, which is exactly what I just told you to do now on the real estate side for cash buyer. Does that make sense? That little methodology just works. So when we started doing that, we needed to automate it so we could take it to scale. This is what that automation looks like. So, I just did this downstairs real quick. I want to go find cash buyers. I go here, I click California, Santa Barbara, hit the continue button. It brings in here 682 people right here, 682 cash buyers that have bought between 0 and 500 properties in the last 90 days in Santa Barbara. Here's 677 of them. I want to go in and just select specific areas of the county I want to market to. I could, for the sake of time, I just selected all of it. And I hit next. And here's every property that just sold for cash in the last 90 days in your county. Here's the buyer's name. Okay, so here's Barbara. Barbara just bought. Oh, come on, scroll back down. She paid up the bottom 1020. She bought this address. There's her phone number, 3-bedroom, 2-bath. That's what she bought. There's her mailing address. And oh, by the way, here's 5 other properties Barbara bought. Who wants to know Barbara? Right? So this is right here in your area. Now if I want to mail them using exactly what I just talked to you, I hit this. I can select them all. I hit print. It'll create the letter for me. I can print it myself, or I can send it to a mailhouse, and it'll print.
Wow.
So in about 5 minutes, I can just take over this market.
Wow.
So somebody asked the question of the last speaker. I didn't know, catch the guy's name. How do you know which markets to go into? Now you know. That's it. We go in, and we say, where is everybody buying? Okay, let me just send some mail. Get my phone ringing, and make sure that I know that they want to buy more. And then I just give it to them. Then, when they say, okay, hey, Ken, it's great, I love it, I hear you, everything, I've talked to you, the cash buyers, man, I'm so excited, I just want to give you money, here's what I'm looking for, bring it to me. And we get that whole list put together. We go right back into the software, and now just show me, we go to the find motivated sellers portion of it. Same thing, California, Santa Barbara, cut off on the side here, but these are all the vacant properties that have hot, that have at least 50% equity that are owned by somebody over the age of 55. All of these are filters that I can go. I can do by square footage, bedrooms, bath, proper use, but I just kept it simple. And proceed. Okay, here's 795 properties right now that are sitting here, vacant, owned by somebody over the age of 55 with at least 50% equity.
Wow.
There they all are. So I hit print again. And now my phone's ringing on the other side. And I'm officially a wholesaler. It's that simple. And again, all you gotta do is get in the game. They're gonna call you. We can make the phones ring. That's the reason I spent 5 minutes on this and 45 on the other side, because we can make the phones ring. I can get you deals like you never had, that you never even thought was possible. None of it matters. And if you don't care enough about it to treat it like a business, because everybody else will just kind of go. You want to be great, do something that looks like greatness. You want to be average? Hey, don't answer the phone. You'll be like, just like everybody else. Okay? And you guys realize that's like, I'm not even joking, that's like a common thing. Like, most of your competition will even do this, and then they stop with, actually answer the phone. They don't do it. They don't even call them back. That sounds insane, but it's the norm, not the exception. That's how mediocre your competition is. So I'll leave you with that. All right, I got a couple minutes for questions here, real quick. Who's got one? Go ahead.
On your motivated sellers, how do you know it's not rented out?
We did go through 23 different checks. Now, the thing about vacant properties, it can be vacant today and not vacant tomorrow, correct? So what I'm telling you is we put on there the date that we've updated it, At the date that we updated it, it was vacant. Could it change? Sure. What's your alternative? Go drive up and down the streets. Right? You want to drive up and down the streets and go waste the one thing I told you you can't waste, which is
time.
Knock yourself out. You want to press a button and hope. Now, keep in mind, you also have to play this game. Again, separating fact from fiction. Let me give you some stats. Does anybody in here actually do direct mail? Okay, so good. This is perfect. Here's the most alarming fact about direct mail. That if you get a 1% response rate, you're killing it. Right? Let me rephrase that. If you fail 99% of the time, you're killing it. If you get a 3 to 5% response rate, you're on fire. Right? Somebody's going to write a book about you. Right? You are on. So the alternative is, yes, go mail 795 people. Okay? Do you know who will actually pick up the phone and call you out of those 795? The people that need your help. Do you know who won't? The people where the property is no longer vacant. But you didn't have to do one thing. You sat there and just did a deal. Your alternative is go drive up and down the streets and go find 795 instances. And hope that you're looking at the ones that are vacant, with the owners over the age of 55, they're financially distressed, which is almost impossible. Right? So again, when you just separate fact from fiction, this becomes a real easy story to tell. You want to just get the phone ringing with the people. So this is why, again, guys, I can go deep. I'm not mailing 70,000 people. Make sense? I'm mailing 700. Yes, sir.
I'm in a kid's programs years ago, and they absolutely will save you a lot of time and not much to pay for to use it. They're excellent. My question to you is, listening to you talk, it sounds like you might probably do 90% of your business of the homes that you actually purchase, maybe 10% of which you wholesale and never purchase. Can you tell me what the percentage rate really is?
That's seven. Well, we market the same way every time. The same marketing. We just decide which bucket we're going to put it in. So when somebody calls me, we have three ways we can work with them. Either I'm going to take that property and I'm going to see it as an opportunity to buy it, rehab it, and go put a tenant in it and sell that as a performing asset. Right? Or, depending on the market, in Phoenix, we would just buy it and sell it. Or I may even wholesale it off. Hey, this isn't a good fit. It's not in the right, you know, the guy lives in the area that we called on, but the property he's trying to sell us is in a different neighborhood. We'll wholesale it.
Do you have a sense of what percent is wholesale and what percent you actually purchase?
It varies, but I would say on any given month, it's probably going to be 75-80% of our deals are being done on turnkey, and the rest just fall into another category.
Okay.
Keep going. Who else got a question for me? No other questions. Did you have one earlier? Did I answer it?
I was wondering where you got this video flyer thing.
I will send that to you guys, right? It's a place out of China that we buy it. But I'm glad you asked that. Let me ask you something. If you got this, what is the intrinsic value? Like, this makes a big impression, right?
Yes.
So what do you think this cost? Now that you know that I got that in China. Right? But I have people call me and when they're like, when you order them in quantity. In quantity, it'd be 500. If I ordered 5,000 at a time, I could probably get it done like $8. With the videos on it, exactly like you see it right there delivered to me.
Yeah, sing it.
Yes, sir.
Is that part of the service that you offer your clients?
What?
When you do service there, to go in different counties, different cities? Or
what I just showed you is if you are an investor, okay, so I have two businesses. I have an investment business. You want to buy houses from me, you can buy it all you want. But if you want to run your own business, that is part of the service we offer. Well, we will give you, you can get this service for as low as $299 a month. You can prepay a year in advance and get 90.
What do you call this service?
SMART. S-M-A-R-T. Strategic Marketing and Real Estate Training. SMART, right? I mean, if you want to buy it right now, that young lady will take your order today, right? Right there, Rita. Hi, Rita. Rita, hold your hands up. Everybody say hi to Rita.
Hi, Rita.
Hi. I told you I wasn't here to sell you anything, but I get it. If you're, hey, man, I just want to get on this. She can get you signed up either at a monthly. If you want to prepay a year in advance, you can do that. You pay a year in advance, you save another $1,600.
Yeah.
So instead of paying $3,600 over a year, you pay $1,990 one time. It's updated every 2 weeks. It has cash buy, try this real quick. Danger, danger, tennis one right here.
Yeah, are you a licensed agent or broker?
Sorry?
No.
Are you a licensed broker?
We have people on our team that are.
Yeah, he's not.
So, there you go. So when you get in there, what it has is cash buyers, private lenders. So here's how we do this. And I've got 1 minute. Cash buyers. We are looking in public records for everybody that bought a house where they didn't record a mortgage. They don't record a mortgage, don't record a note. How they buy it?
Cash.
So that's all proven through public record, right? Private lenders, exact same thing. We go into public record all over the United States. And by the way, when you buy this, you get every county, every city, every state. It isn't just you're going to get Santa Barbara. You get it all. Everything I've got, you've got 100 million records. Private lenders, we go in there and look at people that are acting like the bank. They invested in a property, they recorded a note, it's not a bank, it's not a credit union, it's not a private, it's not a hard money lender, this is mom and pop. They just acted like a private lender. And the marketing is built into it, where you find the private lenders, you hit a button, and then a letter that goes out to them comes from you and says, I noticed you're living on properties, I'd love to talk to you about what I'm doing in this market. It just works. Private lenders, motivated sellers is vacant properties, owner's description being the age of the owner, age of the property, bedrooms, baths. We look at motivation again by vacancy, foreclosure, pre-foreclosure. What else here? I'm just trying to think of this off the top of my head. Can't think of anything else. Now, we are also the only company today, although there are many more coming, right now that can give you the MLS anywhere in the country. So, if you want to go look up all the MLS properties and you're not an agent, done. Right there. You have the MLS for everywhere in the United States. The tax delinquent properties, every tax delinquent property.
That's okay.
Every probate property. It's all just done for you. So, again, I'm not here to sell you on anything, but if you're interested in saving time and you just want to get to the head of the line, I would encourage you to talk to her. If not, then you guys can work it out with Linda or Dan. Hit us up anytime, hit us up on Facebook, we'll gladly help you in any every way we can. I just came up here to see if I couldn't rattle a few cages and help some people out.
Yeah,
that's
also,
all I got.
If you like what you hear from Kent, I run all of our live events, and we have a really great live event in January, so I'm happy to share that information with
yeah,
you all. So
yeah,
if you enjoyed this,
that's
a
good point, that's a good
tactical.
Point. Let me get out of here with that.
Yeah.
I forgot to mention that. So a lot of you hopefully can quickly see that we do things considerably different than just about anybody. There's a reason why so many people have success with what we do. There's a reason why we've been doing this now for 10 or 12 years and have the reputation that we've got. Every year we do an event called the Find Eclipse Summit. This year it'll be happening in Phoenix, Arizona. January 25th, or 26th, 27th, and 28th.
Yep.
There's roughly 500 investors there that will go through nuts and bolts, get into strategies, get into techniques, get into automation, get through all. We've got Grant Cardone. I don't know if anybody knows who Grant Cardone is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he's
so
our
Grant Cardone will be there this year. Frank McKinney will be there this year. Sean Terry will be there this year. Justin Colby will be there this year. Justin Insler will be there this year. This is a who's who business. It's very different for those of you that have been to other events. You haven't been to this one. This is about what it takes to get to the next level. Listen, if you need somebody to teach you how to buy and sell a house, I can tell you, I'm not your guy. And I got zero interest. If you need someone to tell you how to create a machine that'll build hundreds of houses, that'll let you live in La Jolla, California while the businesses are going somewhere else, I probably got something for you. I said it earlier, right? You were asking how many houses, it's 900 houses this year. I couldn't drive you to one of them. I don't know where any of them, literally. But I got paid on every damn one. And that's a business. And if that's something you're interested in, talk to Linda as well. We'll get you tickets. We've got.
I think we have a special program.
Yeah, I told her that with Linda that we would. Right now the tickets are $250. I told her that we would do two, right?
Yeah, two seats.
Two seats for what did I tell you? $299, including the software.
Yeah.
We give them the software and the two tickets, and they can come if they want to do VIP. VIP tickets are $2,000 a piece, where you get to actually hang with us and go an extra day with us. And I told her that we would do two of those for $1,000. So, your choice, do whatever. If anything I've said is compelling to you, I'm going to tell you to get involved. If not, it's been my pleasure. Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much, Ken.
You got it.
Amazing.
Thank you, Ken.
Thank you.
So we're going to take a little bit of a break here, and we're going to have Randy Hughes come up after the break, get you going. But this will give you a chance to, you know, do whatever you need to do for a few minutes, give us a chance to take a little bit of his stuff up here, make sure it's working. Don't go away, we've got a lot of fun days up.
And we do have appetizers coming up. I'm actually going to check on them. We also have awesome speakers in the afternoon.
She's coming back.
Well, we were supposed to be here when it started, hi. And then,
yeah, I'm the vendor.
Oh, you're